project came together when I was in Minneapolis with our bass player, Baker. I was in a rehab and just called up Lane. Baker had been a huge fan of Lane's, and I've known Lane for about 10 years. Called up Barrett, and we got together and rehearsed, and things just started happening.
I was in bed, and he came in and woke me up and said, "You want to play a show in 3 days with these guys?" And I said, "Yeah, sure. You know, when are we going to practice?" And he said, "Well, we'll practice the night before."
We got together and jammed, and it was like, oh, this is kind of cool. And then it always seemed kind of cool. And then now it's turned into something a lot more special than I realized. Resigned to never do anything with it again, and just kind of put it on the back shelf and forgot about it, but then it would come back up occasionally and go, oh yeah, that was cool, we should do something.
I think what sparked it for both of us is that we re-listened to those tracks and realized, wow, this was a really great band, and probably we should find a way for the rest of the world to hear that stuff.
The song is called Long Gone Day. Mr. Mark Lanegan.
We had a bunch of stuff that was left over from the first record, like a whole section of maybe 13 odd ideas that never came to fruition. And I actually have three of those songs with our friend Mark Lanegan singing on top of them, which was a giant bonus. But God knows I'm gone. No sleep. Your countenance falling.
I talked with him and I said, hey, you know, Mike and I want to do a proper reissue of the Mad Season album and the More Theater DVD and really like do a nice package. And so it just became clear that those three songs go with the box set because they're directly connected. You know, Baker played bass on it.
Yeah,
and it was clearly a part of that version of the band.
This is like the greatest musical present to my ears that I have heard, and because I never thought anything was going to happen with it. B, I love how Mark Lanegan sings.
And Mark is a really good lyricist, and when you hear the lyrics that he wrote for those three songs, people will hear the connection to that first Mad Season record. I think the Moore Theater, it's one of those classic music venues. It's smaller than the Paramount. I think it holds close to 1,000 people, you know, like full capacity. And it felt that way amongst everybody in the band. We just really bottled the lightning that night. And I remember the moment we walked out on stage, they were just roaring.
This is the most awesome crowd.
It was really loud. But so many people have tried to find that, and it just wasn't available. Even though the themes on the Mad Season record might be dark, it's a dark beauty, is what it is. And people connect with that because everybody has walked through darkness at some point. It's part of being a human being. But you don't understand the quality of light or the preciousness of it unless you've spent time in the darkness. And somehow, Lane was able to conjure that in his lyrics and in his voice. And we all were able to express that in the way that we played together. And that's why the Mad Season record has this dark beauty to it. It's a very heavy record, but it's also, ultimately, I think it's about ascension and upward movement.